Welcome to the Global War Watch Network. Okay, get this. China just dropped a fighter jet concept that looks like it flew right out of a sci-fi movie. And believe me, this thing could change, well, everything about the future of air combat. So today, we're going to break down what makes this machine so revolutionary.
So this all happened at the recent 2024 Zhuhai Air Show. China's Aviation Industry Corporation, you'll hear them called AVIC, they pulled the curtain back on something truly wild, the Baidi B-Type aerospace fighter. And let me tell you, this isn't just some minor upgrade, no way. This is a huge statement, a bold declaration of just how ambitious China's tech goals really are.
All right, so what exactly are we looking at here? Well, the Baidi B-Type is basically China's blueprint for a sixth-gen fighter. It's the star player in this massive strategy they're calling the Nantianmen Project. And that project? It has one single-minded goal: create a machine that can dominate not just our skies, but near space too. We're talking about a direct challenge to the most advanced air forces on the entire planet.
Okay, so you've got to be wondering, what's really under the hood of this futuristic beast? Let's take a look. Because we're talking about a mix of stealth, firepower, and some serious AI that's aiming to completely rewrite the rules of air superiority.
First up, just look at the design. Yeah, it's sleek, for sure. But those sweeping, contoured lines, they're not just for show. They're pure function. Every curve, every angle, along with those advanced composite materials, is engineered for one thing: to make this jet a ghost on enemy radar. The whole airframe is this incredible balancing act between being almost invisible and still delivering amazing aerodynamic performance at insane speeds and altitudes.
You know, a stealth fighter is only as good as the punch it can pack, right? And the Baidi B-Type hides its arsenal inside an enlarged internal weapons bay. But here's the really clever part. Its true strength is its modularity. What that means is this jet can be a dogfighter loaded with air-to-air missiles one day and then switch to a ground attack role with precision bombs the next. That kind of flexibility on the battlefield, that's a huge, huge advantage.
Okay, now this is where the Baidi goes from being just the fast, stealthy jet to a truly intelligent fighting machine. Think of it this way. It has this cutting-edge sensor suite that's constantly feeding data to an AI-powered brain. A brain that can spot and prioritize threats way faster than any human pilot ever could. And it's built from the ground up for a concept called network-centric warfare. And believe me, that concept changes absolutely everything about how battles are fought.
So, what in the world is network-centric warfare? Well, imagine a digital battlefield. You've got this fighter, you've got unmanned drones, satellites, even troops on the ground, and they're all connected. They're all sharing a single, live, unified picture of everything that's happening in real time. An attack can be coordinated across every single one of those assets, instantly. This really shows you that future combat isn't just about who has the best jet. It's about who has the smartest, most connected network.
But, you know, even with all this incredible AI, the pilot is still at the heart of the mission. The cockpit itself is designed for this perfect synergy between human and machine. So instead of looking down at a bunch of gauges, pilots get all the critical data they need projected right onto their augmented reality helmet display. The controls are ergonomic to cut down on fatigue, which is absolutely critical when you're pulling high Gs at hypersonic speeds on the very edge of space.
Let's be real for a second. The most advanced fighter on Earth is totally useless if it's stuck in a hangar for repairs. That's why AVIC put a huge focus on maintainability. By designing it with modular components, key systems can literally be swapped out in a fraction of the time it would normally take. This whole streamlined process means a much faster turnaround, which keeps more jets in the air, battle-ready, right when it counts the most.
Okay, now let's zoom out for a minute. Let's pull back from the aircraft itself, because this one concept is just a single piece of a much, much bigger puzzle. It's all part of the Nantianmen Project, which really reveals China's true ambition: to control not just the skies we know, but that critical new frontier of near space.
So the official description of the project is, and I quote, "a comprehensive effort to integrate aerospace and near space operational capabilities." Now, what that really means is this isn't just about building a better jet. No, it's about creating a unified combat system that can operate flawlessly from our atmosphere all the way up into the vacuum of space. It's about blurring that line between being a pilot and being an astronaut.
So why does that matter? Why is that such a big deal? Well, operating on the edge of space gives you an enormous tactical advantage.
Think about it. An aircraft flying that high is incredibly difficult to track, let alone intercept, with traditional air defenses. It gives a nation a kind of strategic reach that allows it to respond faster and over much, much greater distances than was ever possible before.
So, what does a concept like the Baidi B-Type really mean for the rest of the world? Well, it means the race for the future of air and space combat has just kicked into a whole new gear. We're talking about a new, more intense phase, one that could totally reshape the global balance of power.
But of course, China isn't doing this in a vacuum. The United States is pushing ahead with its own program, the Next Generation Air Dominance, or NGAD, and Russia is also in the game, pursuing its own advanced fighter technologies. So the reveal of the Baidi B-Type, even just as a concept, is a clear signal to everyone that the competition for sixth-gen superiority is a global, high-stakes race, and it is on.
So what's the bottom line here? The ultimate takeaway is this. If, and it's still an if, this concept becomes a reality, it would be a massive force multiplier for China's military. Now, what that means is it's a piece of tech that doesn't just add one new trick to their playbook. It enhances the effectiveness of their entire military force. It would absolutely reinforce China's position in this global race for dominance in the skies.
And all of this leaves us with one pretty critical question. As these concepts, these things that look like science fiction, get closer and closer to reality, the battle for control of the skies and whatever lies beyond them is really just beginning. The question isn't if this will happen anymore. The real question is, who will rule the skies of tomorrow? Hey, thank you for your time. If you found this breakdown valuable, we'd really appreciate it if you'd like, share, and subscribe to the Global War Watch Network. And we'd love to hear your thoughts on all this down in the comments section. You can also join us over on our social media platforms. All the links for those are right there in the description below.